Workers at South Korean tech giant Samsung begin a general strike after failing to come to terms with management. The National Samsung Electronics Union, whose roughly 28,000 members make up over a fifth of the firm's workforce, had asked the company for commitments such as improvements to its performance-based bonus system and an extra day of annual leave. The union staged a walkout last month, its first such industrial action. But the company at the time said there was no impact on production or business activity. The union now warning of more damaging action against the country's most powerful conglomerate. 456 billion pesos, that's the total amount of revenue collected by the Bureau of Customs in the first half of the year. That figure exceeds the agency's collection target by 3%. It also represents a 5% increase from the revenues collected during the same period last year. Customs Commissioner Bienvenido Rubio attributes this to the enhanced valuation methods and ongoing digitization and modernization of BOC systems. Senator Nancy Binay files an ethics complaint against her colleague Alan Peter Cayetano. It stems from their tense exchange during the recent hearing on the new Senate building. Binay cited Cayetano's name-calling and allegation that she fed the media questions during her radio interviews as basis for the complaint. The two lawmakers had a heated back and forth during the hearing, with Binay insisting the cost of the new Senate building was not 23 billion pesos, and Cayetano countering by citing records from Binay's former committee staff that show the estimate including the cost of the land. Binay now hoping that the Senate Committee on Ethics and Privileges will tackle her complaint when Congress resumes on July 22. BDO kicks off its 5 billion peso fixed-rate sustainability bond offer. This is the third peso-denominated green bond of the Philippine lender after its 63 and 52 billion peso bond offering early this year and in 2022 respectively. Tenor is a 1.5 years, while the rate per annum is at 6.32%. The offer period is until July 19th, listing on the 24th. Proceeds of this will be used to finance assets in its sustainable finance framework and diversify its funding sources. Security Bank also issuing bonds to support its lending activities. It set the minimum size of its offering to 5 billion pesos to be taken out of its 200 billion peso bond and commercial papers program. The bonds carry a 5-year and 1-month tenor with a fixed rate of 5.7% per annum. Offer period is until August 13, with PDEX listing on the 20th of that month. And finally, new president at First Metro Investment Corporation, home to some of our esteemed market analysts here on the program. FMIC named Anthony Ocampo to the post and also as director to succeed Mr. Jose Patricio Dumlao, who had retired from the company. Ocampo brings with him decades of experience in corporate and investment banking from his time at the Metro Bank Group. He was previously the head of global network banking under Deutsche Bank's corporate and investment bank group.